Hi, this is Go. I have with me here the key to the Perodua Axia. Perodua Axia owners for cars which was released between 2014 until 2016. That means the pre-facelift Perodua Axia standard G, SE and advanced have keys like this. So owners are issued keys like this where the alarm remote is integrated into the key housing itself. And as for cars launched, as for post-facelift Perodua Axia, only the standard G is issued keys like this too. Okay, so today we're going to see how to replace the battery which is housed inside the key itself. So what you need is, of course, you need the key and you need the tools, a flat-blade screwdriver or something flat this way, like this, to pry open the key housing. And of course, you also need the replacement battery. So replacement battery, you can see down here. So this is the CR1620. So CR1620 is the battery to replace the to be used for this key itself. Only one battery per key is needed. So to replace the battery, insert the screwdriver into the notch like this, and then pry it up. So once you pry open, you can actually peel it off with your fingers if you have the nails. But as for me, I would like to go it down a little bit down here, and then pry a little bit more so that it opens. But be careful once you open, because this module on the alarm remote module on the inside is not glued, so it can fall off. So be very careful not to cause it to fall on the floor and so on. Okay, locate the back. There is a piece of rubber like this, and there's an end for you to peel off. So you peel off using this end. Just hold this way and it comes off. So that's the battery. There is a notch down here, and there's a notch down here too. So very carefully put one finger on the battery on the opposite end, and then use the screwdriver and pry off the battery. But be careful, you need to hold the battery down a little bit, otherwise the battery will just fly off like that. Okay, so one more time, I show you the battery remover. So pry out like this, take the battery off, and then replace the battery with another one. And then you have to align. You have to make sure that you look at down here, there's two little notch down here. Push the battery underneath the notch like this. You have to keep the positive end on top. This is the positive end. Positive end must be facing upwards, facing towards you. And then push the battery in like this. Okay, once it's inside, flip the key the other way around. Be careful to support the module underneath here. Press to make sure got red light. So when got red light, that means battery is correctly inserted. The next one is to align, put back the cover, align this part here with this little notch down here. Okay, then align like this. Align them this way, and then press around to make it hold in, and then finally take the cover, align the cover, and press until it clicks. Then finally test by pressing the buttons. So once the button press, okay, that means the battery is correctly inserted. Then next thing is go down to the car and test the whether you can open and unlock the car, and then of course start up the vehicle. So I hope this video helps. And there's one more thing. Sorry, I forgot to show you. It's located on the inside of the key itself. Be very careful, do not drop this chip down here. do not drop this, because this one is your immobilizer chip. Be very careful about that one. So do not drop that chip from there. Okay, do not drop that one. Okay, so once you have tightened up, just press. Got light means key, means battery correctly inserted. Next, go to the car, put the key, test it up. So I hope this video helps. Thank you for watching. Till my next video. Bye bye.